Hi, this is José Luis, and before we go into hands-on trying things out, I also wanted to do a quick round of review on the different ways we have for modeling surfaces in general. And this applies to nerve surfaces, but it also applies to other kinds of surfaces. The idea is that, as I explained before, nerve surfaces are driven by control points. But very often, like only in very niche cases, do we actually generate these surfaces by designing the control points one at a time. Typically, what we do is in order to generate these surfaces, we start off from other parameters or we use like simple curves and we follow other processes to generate this form. So, for example, I'm going to run you by a bunch of these examples. And at this point, what I would like you to think is that you might just want to give it a chance to browse through the library of components that are available in Grasshopper, for example, or in Rhino, and take a look at by reading these components and their descriptions to see if you can actually figure out what they do. Because you will find, if you are familiar in general with 3D modeling, you might find that many of these operations are actually quite familiar to you. So, for example, I have here a bunch of geometry that I have generated in Rhino. And remember that all the sample files that we use in this video series, in these tutorials, can be found on the GitHub repository that is linked on the description of this video. So I have here a family of curves and points that I'm going to be using for this definition that I have here, which showcases a bunch of different ways of creating surfaces. So for example, we can create, and if I'm going to drop here bifocals, we can create a four-point surface by inputting the four corners of that surface. So if I take these four points and I fit them into a four-point surface, we can see that we get, as a result, this kind of hyperbolic paraboloid kind of situation. However, if instead I take four boundary curves with any particular shape, and then what I do is I create an edge surface, what you will see is that Rhino will try to fit a surface to the boundary of the four curves that we have defined here. Obviously, it helps a lot if the four curves are ordered properly, and if their edges match each other, and if the endpoints also match, that is super helpful as well. You can find those here under four-point surface or under edge surface. There is also piping. Piping is a very simple surface, which is basically a tube that is extruded along a nerves curve. So, for example, here I have created four pipes that are boundaries to that original surface that I have created. So imagine that we had a structure that had pipes on the edges and it had this cloth or this tarp tensioning between them, for example. The fact that that I said is actually not technically right because a four-edge surface will probably not have the exact same shape as a tensioned fabric. Okay, so forget what I just said. This was a really bad example. Now, if I go down here, you can see that, for example, I can have two profile curves and I can do a rule surface throughout them. Remember that a rule surface is going to be a surface that always is, that is the result of moving a line, a straight line, across a particular trajectory. In this case, using the two curves as the rails for the motion of this straight line. Rule surfaces are very interesting because, for example, they're really useful for creating when you create them with concrete, and you can create the framework. The framework can be created with straight elements, and it's a very nice thing. It makes creating these surfaces much easier in the physical world, for example. But also remember that ruled does not necessarily mean developable. They are two different concepts. Okay. Last, well, it's not last. I can have, for example, three curves here. And then what I can do is I can create a loft, which is basically a surface that is fitted throughout the three curves. So it's ensure that the surface is going to pass perfectly through the three curves. In a way, if you can think, you can think of lofting as a surface that is interpolated over a collection of curves. That's one way to think about it. And then, last but not least, we have sweeping. Sweeping is the operation where you can create a surface by moving one profile curve over another curve as if the other one was the rail on top of which this one is moving. So for example, this one would look something like this. You can see how this profile curve is kind of moving along the rail to generate this undulated surface. Okay. How this works and the mathematics behind each of them, it's kind of complicated at this point, but in general, you can see that any operation for creating surfaces that you might find in Rhino probably has a mirror in terms of a grasshopper component and vice versa. Okay. So in order to create complex surfaces, I highly recommend that you go to Freeform or you go to Primitives and you explore all the operations that you have, all the ways of creating different surfaces. Okay. This is very useful. And if you're doing freeform modeling, you will use a lot of this very often. Okay. Wonderful. So I think we're ready for some hands-on exercises in the next video. Is that what's happening? Are we getting dirty? Alrighty. Let's do it. Thanks a lot. And if you like these videos, click, 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 subscribe, like, like. Thanks a lot. See you on the next video.